Hey guys, alright, so I am here at the Oasia Hotel in Singapore and I'm here for a very special event. Now, we see here, we have an Oppo phone, and not just any Oppo phone, alright? So this is the global launch. I'm actually filming this before the launch starts, alright? I'm trying to get this out as soon as possible, hopefully by tonight, alright? So this is the latest Oppo Find X3 Pro, alright? Now, when I had the opportunity to come for the global event and I was looking at some of the key features of this phone, I had to drop by, right? There's a lot of really amazing features. We're not going to go too much in detail. We'll save that for the review. But anyway, before we talk about the phone, let's see what we get in the box, all right? So this is going to be new for me. I haven't seen the box either. So I'm assuming you get a case. Yeah, you do. Oh, and it's not, okay. It's not your usual clear silicone case. There's a color to it, which is nice. This is obviously the phone. So, as you can see here, there's something cool, but we'll talk about that in a while. So at least you don't get like a clear case, it's an opaque case, which is nice. What else do we get? So, this is the plastic of the foam was here. And we get a charger and a USB Type-C cable. Alright, but anyway, let's take a look at the phone, alright? So there are a lot of really amazing features about this phone. Too much for me to really go through right now because I'm trying to keep this short. But we'll go through some of the main features and then we'll save the rest for the review, alright? So, I think one of the first things you're going to realize is the back of the phone, right? Now, if you look here, now every other phone, including my phone, a lot of other phones, when you have your camera module, it's more of something that that looks like it's put on top of the phone, alright? It doesn't blend the way this one does. So, if you see here, it actually sort of goes up and flushes with the camera module. Now, to a lot of people, this may not seem like a big deal. But to me, it really is, because first of all, this is not plastic, all right? This is a kind of glass material. Now, to get glass to bend in this sort of form, it's no, like, small feat. It's really amazing that they managed to get it to look this way. And even though it's glass, it's got this sort of like a rubber matte finish. I actually thought that this was a plastic cover or a casing over, but no, this is the phone. This is the case. So, I don't know exactly what kind of material this is, but we'll need to figure out. But this looks actually really cool. I'm touching it with my finger. I'm a little sweaty because I ran a bit before we started shooting this, but there's absolutely no fingerprint. This actually looks really nice. And on the screen, all right. So before we talk about the screen, let's talk about the specs. So this, obviously being one of Oppo's flagship phones, you're going to get one of the best chips around. And this has the Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 5G CPU or APU or whatever you want to call it. But yeah, so that is basically the best that you can get from Qualcomm right now. You get 12 gigabytes of RAM, you get 256 gigabytes of storage. I don't know whether there are variants that gives you more, but right now, according to the spec, at least for this particular phone, it has that RAM and that particular storage. Right now, in terms of battery, there are actually a couple of really cool things. Now, in battery capacity wise, it's good. I mean, not amazing, but you get 4,500 mAh battery, which is really, really cool. Especially in a phone this size, I would have expected it to be, you know, like just below 4,000 or maybe about 4,000. But the fact that they managed to squeeze a 4,500 mAh battery in this phone is pretty impressive. But not just that, all right? So you get Oppo's, you know, very famous 65-watt SuperVOOC charging 2.0, all right? Which means that you can charge from about 0 to 40% in about, I think it was 10 minutes or something like that. Let me see if I have the details here. I don't have it here, but yeah, it's really, really quick. Not just that, even your wireless charging, all right, you get 30 watts of wireless charging, which I think is one of the most that I've seen so far. The only other one I think is from another brand, but not just that. So you do get reverse wireless charging. So that means if I had something that wireless charge, something like this maybe, and yes, there are other products they are launching, but maybe, I don't know if this wireless charges, but if you have something that wireless charges, you can put it here, and you get wireless charging from the phone. Now, a lot of other phones that have wireless charging usually is about 5 watts. You get double that. You get 10 watts of wireless charging, which I think is a first for me. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, 10 watts is pretty impressive. And in terms of the operating system, you get Android 11, and you also get Oppo's ColorOS 11.2. Now, we recently did an unboxing and a review of the Reno 5 Pro. I believe that was ColorOS 11.0 or 11.1, but this is 11.2, so it's their latest version. And honestly, with the 11 ColorOS version, I was a real big fan of it. I thought it was really nice. And looking at it straight away, it looks very similar. I'm sure there are some other features, but I mean, like what I mentioned, In my review of the Reno 5 Pro, what I really appreciated was the level of customizability that you get with ColorOS, and it's no different here, right? The amount of customizability is really, really impressive. But the key features of this phone is really got to do with the screen and its camera, all right? So we'll talk about the screen first. Now, Oppo markets this as a billion color phone. Now, what they mean by that really is, it's got a lot to do with the screen. Now, this is, to my knowledge, the first screen with a 10-bit panel, all right? So this is an AMOLED screen. Now, most screens, or I think every other screen, is usually 8-bit. Now, you may think that 8-bit to 10-bit might be a small, you know, jump up, but not really. In terms of color bit rate, from 8 to 10 gives you 64 times more color, all right? So with that sort of calculation, you're looking at 1.07 billion colors that this panel can produce, all right? So that's why they call it the billion color phone. And I mean, right now, off the bat, looking at the screen, you can't really tell. I'll be very honest. It's something that you really need to put it through the paces with videos and maybe some other stuff. Then you can really see the difference in the screen. But also in terms of color accuracy, so in the DCI-P3 coverage, it has full 100%, which is really impressive. Now, in terms of resolution, now a lot of phones have stuck with the full HD plus resolution, all right? Now, this one has taken it a step up, all right? So you get QHD plus resolution. So let me get the resolution here. So it is 3216 by 1440, so basically a 1440p panel. So that's 2K, or some call it QHD. But because of the aspect ratio, they call it QHD plus. And in terms of the screen, in terms of your like screen to body ratio, now this has, according to Oppo, 92.7% screen to body ratio. And I think that's one of the highest I've seen so far. Probably one of the highest available, easily top five. But yeah, if you look at it, from the wallpaper, you can't really see, but you do have a selfie cutout here. If I were to go to something else that's fully white, then yeah, you can see you have a selfie punch here, but it's really small. But other than that, the bezels are pretty thin. You will realize though, it does have a curved screen. I don't know if the other camera can pick it up, but you do have a curved screen. It's not as curved as some of the others. And if you've seen any of my videos, you know I'm not a fan of screens that have curved phones. This one does, but at least half of the curve is taken by the bezel. So that's not really too bad. Another really cool feature, color-wise, is that it has a color enhancement mode. Now, there are people around who use phones. I mean, everybody has a phone nowadays. And there are some people who have a certain level of color blindness. Now, color blindness doesn't necessarily mean you only see black and white. There's a lot more to it than that, all right? With color blindness, I'm not going to pretend to be an expert, but you do see different colors differently. Now, Oppo has even looked at that. And what they do is that they have something called color enhancement mode. I'm going to get some of the details here because it's quite a lot of stuff. So they have 765 color correction solutions. So if you have some sort of color blindness, you can actually use this, find out, try and, I think it's like a calibration mode to find out your level of color blindness, and it will actually adjust the colors for your own color blindness. And that is one of the most amazing features and really well done, Oppo. I don't think any other phone manufacturer has anything remotely close to that. So that's really good. Now, apart from the design and how it looks, now, this is something that I've been complaining about for a really long time. If you've seen any of my phone reviews, when it comes to talking about cameras, I always say the same thing. There is always an issue in terms of color uniformity, in terms of your color correction or the color science from the different camera modules. So all phones have many different camera models now, whether it's a tri setup, whether it's a quad camera setup. This one is a quad camera setup, and we'll talk specifically what they are in a bit. But what I love is that the main camera and the ultra wide uses the exact same sensor, all right? And that's a really big deal, because if a lot of you take pictures, especially at night, it might not be as obvious during the day, but if you take a picture at night, what you might realize is that on the main, it looks pretty good. But then when you take a night shot with the ultra wide, it doesn't look as good. A lot of times, the night mode is really just not up to par. Now, this uses the exact same sensor. So this uses Sony's latest IMX766 sensor. And it's a 50 megapixel sensor, all right, on both the main and the ultra wide. Now, that is a huge deal, all right? This is the first time that they would actually have the same expensive module on both the main and ultra wide. So I'm really excited to test it out. And yes, I will be getting a set to bring home, to test out, to do a full review. So don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss that. Now, like I mentioned, this is a quad camera setup, all right? So you've got your main, you've got your ultra wide. I'm assuming this is the main, or I don't know which one. But anyway, you also have a 13 megapixel telephoto lens. Now, like I said, a lot of times I don't really find it that useful. We'll still see if that's still the case. But if you take a look here, you have a tiny little camera sensor here. Now, that's not a flash. That is not like a depth sensor. This is a micro lens, all right? Now, I think this is the first for me. Have you seen anything like that? No, right? Yeah. So this allows you to take microscopic shots, all right? Now, I'm going to give you one good example. So we have this cloth here, very simple cloth. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the camera. I'm going to go to the micro lens now. And then there's a mode called microscope. Yeah, so if you look here, you go to more, there's a microscope function here. So if I press that, if I go down, and I don't know if the camera's going to pick that up, I'm just going to put it a bit down and you get a microscopic shot. That's incredible. So I'm just going to do one here and then I'm going to take a picture. All right, so I'm going to show it here. Look at that. It's a microscopic shot on a phone. So yeah, that's pretty much a lot of the amazing features. Now, I haven't had a chance to fully test it out, but already I'm super impressed. Oppo has really gone out of their way to make this phone really stand out. And as you know, with a lot of flagship phones nowadays, they tend to find it very difficult to stand out. They all have the best specs, blah, blah, blah. But it's really in the other features that would really set a flagship phone apart. And right now, first impressions, I'm really impressed. This has the potential to be one of the most major phones of the year, if not the most major phone of the year. In terms of Android ability, now it's a flagship phone, so I'm not going to expect it to have any issues in terms of usability for Android, so I'm not going to focus too much on that, especially with this first impressions video. But anyway, so yes, do look out for the full review coming out really soon. But in the meantime, I'm JP. I'll see you guys real soon.